In the latest attempt to save Deputy President William Ruto and Joshua Arap Sang against ICC, a section of members of the National Assembly are seeking intervention of the Assembly of State Parties meeting next month to see the process used by former ICC prosecutor Moreno Ocampo to identify and recruit witnesses in the Kenyan cases investigated.
And this petition is made under Article 112, subsection 4 of the Rome Statute, which is giving ASP and the United Nations an opportunity to form an independent mechanism to audit.
This institution, if it proceeds in the manner that it is proceeding, it is failing international justice. And it is failing international standards of jurisprudence, and it is failing international standards of natural law and natural justice.
Through a petition addressed to the UN Security Council and the President of the Assembly of State Parties, the legislatures won the cases against William Ruto and Joshua Arap Sang adjourned, accusing the prosecution for failing to work with diligence.
We are suspecting that it was cut and paste from other documents of other institutions, and therefore the office of the prosecutor never did diligent work. And in that sense, we cannot sacrifice our brothers. In that sense, we cannot keep quiet. And there's no better time of this petition than now.
While receiving the petition, Foreign Affairs Ministry Principal Secretary Engineer Karanja Kibisho said the ministry will fast-track its submission to the Assembly of State Parties.
We shall be transmitting this petition to New York through our permanent representative, Ambassador Masharia, who will then, through a diplomatic note, pass it to the president of the Assembly of State Parties.
The petition came even as members of the National Assembly remain divided on whether to form a select committee to investigate the Waki report's content. The move also comes just a day after Gatundu South Member of Parliament Moses Kuria recorded a statement with a team of investigators from the ICC over his fixing claims. Ben Chumba, reporting for Channel One News Hour.